If you know me pretty well, you probably know I really, really do not like being in front of people. But when I know that I am doing it for God, He gives me the power and confidence to do it. He gives me the power and confidence to live the life that He wants me to live, to share His truth and to live it out. The first two summers after high school, I was still going to the church that I grew up in, and I was the VBS director. And coincidentally, the themes for those years were water themes. So I was Captain Tyler, and wearing a captain hat can give you confidence. It was something that was out of my comfort zone. I was not confident in being a director. As the director, I had to do a few things in front of people. I luckily had a good team, and they were able to take care of a lot of the things that I wasn't very good at. My mom was on the team. She was in charge of music. She is great with leading motions and songs. And so she was able to get all the kids excited about it. And I didn't really have to worry about doing any of that upfront kind of stuff. I had to do a few things, but they were pretty minor. But as director, it came time for me to step up and do something that I was not confident in doing at all. My mom was busy with something else, and most of the kids had gathered together for the closing. How am I supposed to entertain all of these kids? You'd think that growing up with my mom being so good at leading motions and doing motions every year in church and VBS, but no, it does not run in my blood. My brain is just not really equipped to keep up with it all. But I knew there was one song that I was good at, one song that I could lead well enough that it would keep the kids entertained. That is Father Abraham. If you have seen the song Father Abraham done right, it's awesome. And really, all it is flailing your limbs around and trying not to kill the person standing next to you. So it worked out pretty well, but God gave me the confidence and the strength to do what I needed to do, and to do it with enough confidence that it went well, because sometimes all you need is to be confident for something to work out. Trust me, I have plenty of experience in things not working out because I'm not confident enough. Be confident when you are serving God, and He'll take care of it. And when I say serving God, I don't just mean being a VBS director or VBS helper. I mean whatever you do. Have confidence. Be bold. If you're not sure how your friends are doing right now in quarantine, check on them. If you're not sure of yourself in things that you have to do, be bold. If you're living the life that God wants you to live, you can have confidence that He's going to work it out. There are two reasons why you can have confidence with God. One, if you're living for Him, God's got your back. He has your back. He will take care of you. And secondly, if you are living for God, God has a plan. The more you trust God, the more you follow Him, the better the plans get. God has great plans for you. He has given you so much potential. He knows you can do so much in life. Romans 8:28 says, "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to His purpose for them." Be confident and bold when you live for God. In what areas are you lacking confidence in your life? And how does God want to give you confidence for those things? How does God want you to be bold? For me, sometimes it's just checking on friends. Sometimes I think, oh, I don't want to bother them. Be confident. Check on them. Sometimes there are things that you should do or need to do. Have confidence when you do them. Do them with God. Ask Him to help you. Ask Him for strength, and He will help you. Trust Him. Talk to Him. Remember scriptures like Romans 8:28. God's going to work things out. It doesn't mean that everything's going to work out great. But in the end, He has a great end goal. And if God has your back and He has a plan, you're all set. Be confident.